Hello and welcome YouTube to another Gunnar Souls video. Today we are going to be discussing what has just happened in the North London Derby with Aubameyang being dropped. That's correct people, the club captain was dropped for disciplinary reasons according to Arteta. We will get into exactly what is going on with Aubameyang this season. What is going on, Gooners and Football Nation? Now, do we have one hell of a breaking news? Arteta dropped his club captain, his talisman, and the club's highest earner in a PA, Emerick Aubameyang, for the clash against Tottenham. Now, what do we read into this? But before we get into that, please subscribe, like, and share, people, because there's a lot more content like this coming up as well, where I'm going to be a little bit more level-headed and looking at what is going on with Arsenal Football Club and what can we digest, because I feel like that's more important. Now, as we all know, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang dropped for Tottenham in the North London Derby, people. Now, for people who aren't Arsenal fans and are going to be watching this content, just to let you know, this is one of the biggest derbies in Arsenal football clubs, like fixtures and everything. This is like the El Clasico. This is like Celtic Rangers. This is like the Manchester Derby. It's a feisty derby. It's one of the ones we look forward to. It's one of the games where we pretty much stamp this, you know, as Arsenal fans. And this is the one where we take our days off from work as well. Now, obviously, before the game, the bombshell dropped that Mikel Arteta came out and said that his club captain, talisman, Aubameyang, is being dropped for disciplinary reasons, later on finding out that he was late to turn up for the preparations for the game. Now, if anyone knows anything about football, that tends to what does tend to happen. You've got to be on time for your warm-up before the game, otherwise injuries can happen and a lot of different things can happen. You know, tactical meetings happen then as well. So there's a lot of things that does go on. If you're late for it, you're never going to play the game, you know. Did Arteta do the right thing? Of course he did. Was it right for him to expose the reasons? Of course it is. We asked for a transparent manager. We asked for a manager who was going to be transparent with his fans. And we wanted a board who were going to be transparent with the people. And that's what we got. So I don't know why we're complaining as a fan base that he came out and told us exactly what the reasons are. Now, it sends a statement to the club. It sends a statement to the squad that no one's bigger than the squad. That's exactly what I want to be seeing, you know, as an Arsenal fan. I want to be able to sit there and say that my manager is going to discipline people regardless of name and stature. Now, has this affected the game? Not at all. We still won. We were still fired up. We were still playing with a lot of passion. Now, it did seem like Aubameyang was supposed to start this game, but from the game plan, it didn't seem that way to me. So it was quite an interesting one from Arteta. Now, for me, you know, and the big question that Arsenal fans are asking is, does Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang deserve to be club captain? Now, I've always said it, I don't think he's got the leadership skills to be a captain, but he is a big, big personality within the dressing room, and dropping him, stripping him off of the captaincy may affect team morale. That's my biggest concern when we do this, and it has to be done right. Now, of course, we know there's one man, Kieran Tierney, who deserves to be club captain. You know, he's the one with the passion. He's the one with the fire. He's the one, every time you see him on the pitch, the one firing up the lads. You know, he's got that leadership. He's got this no bullshit about him. You know, he's a no-nonsense player. Very humble, down to earth. You know, he seems to be one of those that, you know, he sticks to his roots. You know, he's a traditional fullback. He's a traditional style player, shirt tucked in, professional, ready to go, as if like any other job. That's the reason why we feel so connected to him. Now, I wanted to just bring up a few things as well about Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang and his season so far. In the Premier League, he has played 23 games and scored 9 goals and assisted 2 yellow cards in 1,853 minutes. In the Europa League, he has played 4 games, scored 3, 2 against Benfica, and I cannot remember who he scored against in the group stages. In the Community Shield, obviously you're only going to play once, and he scored against Liverpool. In the FA Cup, you know, he's played 1 game and scored 1, resulting in 29 matches played, 14 goals and 1 assist in 2,347 minutes. And just to kind of give you a comparison, I'm just going to bring up his last season. So in total, he played 3,725 minutes in total in the Premier League, playing 36 matches, scoring 22 goals, getting 3 assists and 3 yellow cards and a red card. In the Europa League, playing 6, scoring 3. In the FA Cup, obviously, we know the madness he went on near the end. In 2 matches, he scored 4 goals, which was, you know, which we've seen. Absolutely brilliant in the FA Cup. He was 44 games, 29 goals, 3 assists in 3,725 minutes. Now, which means, you know, he needs to get... So he scored 14 in total he's so far this season. And last season he scored 29, meaning he needs 15 goals in the remainder of the season, which he can do. So he can bring his goals back. But will he do that? I don't think so. I really don't see his head being in the game as much as he usually is. His mentality for quite a while now has been off the game, off the pitch. Obviously, at the start of the season, just before the Leeds game, he took a break. I can't remember who he missed out against now, due to family reasons, his mother not being well. So obviously, which we can understand, but I just feel like if that is the case, if that's the way, you know, like your head's not in the game, you've got to be kind of man enough to kind of admit that, you know, you can't play football at the moment. It's just the right thing to do for the fan, for the clubs. And I think people won't turn on you. But now you can't be using that as an excuse every time a bad performance happens. He scored the hat-trick against Leeds. He brought us back against Benfica and actually won us that tie. So he has done things. But unfortunately, it's just coming to a point where he's disappearing from a lot more games than he's actually involved in. Even when you look at the Olympiacos game, it seemed like he was working harder to disappear from the game than actually involve himself in that game. And that's becoming a concern for a lot of fans. And then obviously he turns up late to, you know, match preparation. Look, it happens, you know, the traffic is unpredictable at times. It's a North London derby. It can happen. But unfortunately, as a club captain, you're held to higher standards and you can't be just let off because circumstances have changed things. And to be honest with you, when the news broke out as well that the players were also actually backing the manager on this decision, on the dropping of Aubameyang, it kind of is now starting to send the statement that will it matter if he's dropped from the captaincy, if he's stripped away from the captaincy? He seems to be losing that element of backing from the players. If the news of the players being fine with it is you know, to be believed. And I do think because it's multiple sources reporting this, it's becoming kind of concerning for Aubameyang. Is it the curse of signing the ting? Because we can see what happened to Ozil after he signed a mega deal. Now, Aubameyang, the unfortunate thing is he demanded this big contract, whereas Ozil was handed a contract due to the circumstance of Alexis Sanchez leaving, and they couldn't lose both, otherwise the fan base would have gone absolutely ballistic. And especially losing them both for free, which with Ozil, it ended up happening. We ended up paying him out to leave. But, you know, saying that, we didn't want to lose them both. We didn't even want to lose Sanchez, to be honest. And now Aubameyang signing a mega deal with Arsenal. Is it just a curse of signing the contract and getting this mega deal? Does it make them lack ambition? Does it make their determination less? That is a, you know, a question which is soon going to be answered. And I think, you know, he's coming more and more less of a captain for me and more of a person who's, I don't know. I don't even miss him. I don't even see him in games anymore. I don't see him trying to up the boys and, you know, get them passionate again and make them believe in themselves again, that which a captain needs to be doing. So it's just one of those where it's becoming quite concerning. And if he was stripped of the captaincy, I don't think it'll make a big impact that it was given to Tierney. But I don't think that'll happen this season. I think Arteta's too much his approach is too professional to strip him unless he went and did something like what Xhaka did, let's say. That would be the only way I think a captaincy would be changed within the season. I just think Arteta's approach and conduct isn't that, you know, it's a professional manner he does it in. So on that, obviously, I don't see it happening, and I still think he will be club captain. I just think he's having a rough few weeks or a rough few months, even with what happened after Burnley, with the comments that he made on Twitter about, oh yeah, we created chances, you know, it just wasn't our day, it is what it is, isn't really what I want to be hearing from my club captain when we've just drawn a game we should have won, a game that we lost because we couldn't be asked winning it. You know, it's as simple as that. And then obviously leading up to that, to go into Olympiacos, to disappear from the game, movement was all off. It just seemed like he didn't care. He wasn't bothered. He was trying harder to not impose himself or be on the ball. But saying that, obviously, that is what the situation with Aubameyang and Arteta was. Arteta right 100%. No one's bigger than the squad. No one's bigger than the club. And it sent a statement that even in a big game like this, one of the biggest players in the club was dropped. I'm not saying Lacazette couldn't do a job. Of course he can. But to drop your best player, let's say, I know people are going to say Saka, but I'm just talking generally, like one of the biggest names on that team sheet is Aubameyang. Of course, you know, it's Saka FC at the minute. It's, you know, Saka is carrying this club. But in terms of just generally over the seasons, you know, Aubameyang has been one of our biggest players in terms of just his name, what he brings to the club. So to drop someone like that is, you know, it's a statement, let's say. And it shows he's got this locker room respecting him and wanting to play for him. But that is all I've got to say today. And do leave your comments down below. What are your thoughts on the whole Aubameyang Arteta saga? Well, it's not even a saga. It's the British media doing what they do best and turning it into one. But do we think Aubameyang deserves to be captain? And what are your thoughts on the whole situation? Do you agree with Arteta? Or do you think there would have been a different way to approach this? But this has been Gunnar Souls. Do please subscribe, like, and share. And this is going to be a different style of video. If you do like it, please let me know. It's more level-headed. It's not me being so energetic and just kind of delivering news and breaking point of Arsenal Football Club. Thank you very much for tuning in. And I hope you guys have a blessed day.